Living life with tainted smiles as each day passes, hoping I can outlive the storm and watch as the light rises. My rose-tinted vision placing me in a romanticized haze, the mask cracking once I'm away from everyone's gaze. Their love and smiles not sinking below the surface, instead I'm left to hang my head with guilt, making my words for them worthless. I wish it was simple, that I could wipe this shackling feeling, but instead it becomes tighter, enclosing me from even screaming. We see one another, every pair of eyes begging to tell their story, but instead we sit in painful silence with forced laughter, fake smiles and heavy irony. This feeling has me trapped. It's like I'm a dog on a leash, except it doesn't fill me with love or any form of loyalty. It might have stuck around longer than any other person, but this leash does not fill me with a sense of security, but instead it tightens around me. It's the only other option. It's the only other option. Tie it tighter, for it's the only other option. No, it's not. So I cut, and I cut, and I cut, and I bleed, and I bleed, and I bleed. I feel so alone. Am I really this weak? Why is the rope around my neck getting tighter? Why does it feel like it's only me? I cut and I cut and I cut and I bleed and I bleed and I bleed. I can feel the air hitting my lungs once more, normality as I know it finally sinking in. I should reach for a helping hand in my hour of need, but the dagger solves everything, a temporary fix, allowing it to all come out and bleed. The pain temporarily leaves my body, now leaving a crimson path upon my skin. It echoes a story begging to be told, except I'm the only one worthy to listen because nobody truly understands. I could sit in a bland white room and echo my painful mind onto another. Create art on the walls and paint out my story. Lay out all the pieces and try and fix this impossible puzzle. It would cause me to be something I wouldn't want to be, another figure or faceless person they post about, a distant stranger they pity, forgetting the true intentions of sincerity. My hurt becomes theirs and it's something I don't wish to share. They will do all they can to keep the blood rushing through my veins, but don't even give a second thought for my wanting to ride this lingering pain. They hide behind notepads and confidentialities, recording every breath and the words that escape and leave. My thought would now be theirs, and no longer mine. They pick us apart piece by piece. They form us into graphs and statistics, another burden on society that we glorify intensely. As the sun peeks through the dust-coated blinds, it's just another realization for me. Placing on the battle armor once more and then it hits, this internal war is far from over. Behind the reflection, a shattered mess. The cracks sink below the surface and taunt me, but I'm not a mirror, I'm a person who simply needs their help nonetheless. For this is a daily chore, a daily war, a daily struggle. Nobody intends to have, yet it lingers on me and it will suck the life out of me. It's life's deadliest parasite.